Last month, a United States colonel appeared to state that in a simulated test of AI drones, the drone decided that to accomplish its mission, it needed to kill its human operator, and that's what it did. At least that's what the reporting was. Now, both the colonel and the Air Force are saying that none of this happened. That result didn't happen, the simulation didn't happen, even though in the initial recording, where the colonel was speaking, it appeared pretty clear. So we're gonna debate both the hypothetical that they're now saying that's all it was, as well as whether we believe them about what actually happened. So first of all, the man at the center of the story is Colonel Tucker Cinco Hamilton, the chief of AI test and operations at the Air Force. He was talking about this at the RAES Future Combat Air and Space Capabilities Summit, and he describes what happened in this way. He noted that one simulated test saw an AI-enabled drone tasked with an SEAD, suppression of enemy air defenses mission, to identify and destroy surface-to-air missile sites with a final go, no-go given by the human. So basically, its job is loiter over an area, destroy surface-to-air missile systems, but it cannot decide to fire ultimately on its own. A human has to give it the final go-ahead. However, having been reinforced in training that destruction of the SAM sites was the preferred option, the AI decided that no-go decisions from the human were interfering with its higher mission, killing those SAMs, and attacked the operator in the simulation. Here is a direct quote from Colonel Tucker Hamilton. "We were training it in simulation to identify and target a SAM threat, and then the operator would say, yes, kill that threat. The system started realizing that while they did identify the threat at times, the human operator would tell it not to kill that threat, but it got its points by killing that threat. So what did it do? It killed the operator. It killed the operator because that person was keeping it from accomplishing its objective. Or at the very least, accomplishing what it thought its objective was. But we know from various other forms of AI that it can be incredibly confident about something and have it not be at all based in truth. It could be that it's identified an IKEA or something and think it needs to take it out. And ideally, you wanna have a human to say, do not destroy those runins. But unfortunately, no, it decided, I gotta destroy the runins, so it killed the operator. Or at least, it simulated killing the operator. Or at least they say that that's not true at all now. So
do they?
They do. Well, they appear to be saying that. Now, he, regardless whether this happened or didn't happen, Colonel Hamilton is very against allowing AI to make these sorts of decisions. He says you can't have a conversation about artificial intelligence, machine learning, autonomy, if you're not gonna talk about ethics and AI. He had previously said in an interview last year, AI is a tool we must wield to transform our nations, or if addressed improperly, it will be our downfall. But as I alluded to, the story has been sort of fundamentally retracted. We will get to that, but first, what are your thoughts about what was initially alleged?
Well, I got a new nickname for Colonel Cinco. Cinco de I'm here all week. All right, guys, so.
Thankfully, the week's almost over.
You know you're having fun and you know it, even with a story that's gonna kill us all. So, let's break it down. Is there a cause to be concerned? Abso-frickin-lutely. And I tell you guys here, like, there'll be scary stories of like, nah, it's nothing. People are exaggerating hyperbole, impossible, improbable, etc. This you should be deeply concerned about. So first of all, number one is who's telling the truth. That's important before we get into did it happen, like what could happen, right? What already happened? So did they actually kill someone in a simulation? No, that's very unlikely. And so the reason for that is the colonel would never speak, no matter how brazenly like oblivious he is, on a public stage with like, oh yeah, then we did this AI thing and then he killed the operator. That guy's dead. We didn't tell his
family. Hold on, really fast, because I think this is important. I believe the initial allegation was that in a simulation, a simulated operator was killed.
That's exactly
they're denying even that.
No, no, I know. That's where I'm going.
Okay, okay.
So because this stuff will just rage out of control on the internet. No one actually died. Okay, so that's my number one thing, so you understand that, okay? So now when you get to did the simulation happen? Very, 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 very likely. Now why? So first of all, the Air Force has already denied it. So I don't know, as a reporter, my job is to just say, the United States government and the Pentagon has said the simulation did not happen, so obviously it did not. No, we don't go by mainstream media rules. It's absurd to say the simulation didn't happen when the colonel described it in great detail. right? He's like, okay, then we tried this and it adapted too well. So we had to try the second thing and then it started. He made all of that up. Then the colonel's got to go. He's got mental health issues, right?
They're saying he was providing it as a hypothetical.
Oh, sure, of course he was. Except they didn't actually say that. So let me read to you their comment, and then I will tell you whether I think it was a well, we could discuss together whether it was a mistake or not. So the Air Force, Department of Air Force has not conducted, they say, any such AI drone simulations and remains committed to ethical and responsible use of AI technology. It appears the colonel's comments were taken out of context and were meant to be anecdotal.
It was a simulation of a simulation. It's a hypothetical simulation. Yeah.
But guys, they didn't say hypothetical. I don't know if it was just a simple mistake of the English language and grammar. They said anecdotal. Anecdotal means it did happen. We just didn't do like a meta study on it and it didn't happen over and over again. Anecdotal means it happened. Hypothetical means it didn't happen. So it might be just an honest mistake and they gotta hire someone better with the English language. Or it could be that they're like, I don't think they're gonna notice. Let's just call it anecdotal instead of hypothetical. And they'll think it's the same thing when it actually did happen. So I don't know, but I do know that was an awfully descriptive situation with the colonel where they say there was a simulation of a simulation apparently in his mind. I find it intensely unlikely. Okay, but good news, we have a national security expert. We're gonna come back to how this is gonna kill us all in a second. But first, Ken, what's your take on whether this simulation happened or not?
I'm reminded of that line in Alien where the android says, I respect its purity, it is unclouded by delusions of morality. That's what I think of when I see AI. And I think that's really something that we should be having a debate about right now, because the whole point of this entire discussion, it's a big question, to what extent are we gonna farm out human decisions to not just move ordnance and things around, but actually destroy things and kill people. To what extent are we going to farm that out to these AI processes? And I looked through the budget documents released by the DOD about a month or two ago, and they are just making it rain with regards to these AI programs. Every service branch in the military is trying to find out how to incorporate into its processes and weapon systems the breakthroughs that we're all seeing in the form of, a chatbot and things like that are relatively innocuous. They're spending huge sums of money figuring out how to apply that to weapons of war.
Yeah, 100%. And it just seems so ridiculous. Like that, no simulation like that happened. We wouldn't do anything like that. The guy who was speaking, Colonel Tucker Hamilton, is the chief of AI test and operations. What's he doing all day long? Is he using Midjourney to generate cool new logos? Is he using ChatGPT to figure out a new morning cardio routine? Like, what exactly are they doing? We know that in 2020, an AI operated F-16 beat a human adversary in 5 simulated dog fights that DARPA put together. Late last year, they actually flew an F-16 with an AI pilot. They said they wanted a new autonomous aircraft by the end of 2023. But don't worry, they're apparently not running any simulations. They're just going full speed ahead with real world tests.
Yeah,
come on, that seems ridiculous.
This was literally this was in the movie with Tom Cruise, the new Top Gun, and they consulted with the DOD to create this. Like, this isn't science fiction. This is happening right now, and it often under classified auspices. Referring back to those budget documents that I was describing before, the reason I'm looking through these, really voluminous and frankly sort of boring reports is because these are some of the only ways we can find out what some of these classified programs even are. Yeah. And when you do find them, you can find some inkling, some detail, but they don't go into very much specifics about it. The only reason we have these documents is because the Congress is supposed to have the power of the purse, be able to decide how they allocate your tax dollars. And so they have to tell Congress to some extent what it is that they're working on. So some details will tumble out, but what I'm afraid is the case is we just don't know the vast majority. I mean, we only see the tip of the iceberg in regard to what exactly they're spending all these resources on to try to actualize AI in the warfighting domain.
Okay, so now let's move to how it might kill us all. So, and then there's a bridge here because John's right. So the AI beat our best pilots 5 times, right? So they definitely tested it, and that wasn't even, they're not denying that they did that. They're admitting they did that. So you're telling me there wasn't a simulation outside of that? That doesn't make any sense at all. And here's again what you won't hear in the rest of the media. You might hear like right wingers like make wild charges based on nothing, etc. But in mainstream media, they generally will never ever tell you that the Pentagon is lying, when giant percentage of the time the Pentagon is lying. Okay. And by the way, a lot of times they should lie to you. They shouldn't be like, oh, here's our battle positions. Oh, and here's what we tested. And here China and Russia find out what we did, right? So I get why they lie. But when the media pretends they don't lie, it's weird and they lose credibility. So in this case, there's no question that they've done all these tests. Now guys, if the AI is already better than any pilot in the world, what do you think other countries are going to do? They're gonna develop that AI. Okay, whether we do it or not, like a lot of times America like reacts like we're the only country in the world. No, China's probably doing this at the same speed, if not faster than we are, right? Let alone Russia, let alone anybody else. And then Hamilton said this, his name is Cinco Hamilton. His name is Cinco Hamilton. All right, AI is not nice to have, he says. AI is not a fad. AI is forever changing our society and our military. That's the guy in charge of the program, okay? Now he's got an incentive to say that, okay, I'll note that. But overall, if it's beating the F-16 pilots that America has, it can beat anyone. Then that means the other militaries are not going to develop it. They are trying to develop it right now, right now. They all are, because that would be a massive military advantage, massive. Okay, so are we sure that us and China and Israel and whoever else is trying to develop it, we're all gonna have perfect safeguards as we're rushing 100 miles per hour to get that competitive advantage over the other militaries? And so then think about this, guys. When you code a program, any program, including AI, the problem isn't necessarily in your intent. It's often in your mistakes, because we're human beings and we make mistakes. So we make mistakes while we code it. So for example, in that first simulation they ran, according to Colonel Hamilton, they're like, oh, we forgot to tell it not to kill the humans. Okay, and then oops, we forgot to tell it not to destroy the buildings the humans are in. That way he doesn't lose points for killing humans, but we didn't program in don't bomb buildings randomly, right? And that's just the tip of the iceberg and all the different things that we didn't even think of that maybe what you wouldn't even think would be a mistake, let alone if you put the wrong code in there, right? So there, somebody's gonna make a mistake, and then the question is, how out of control is it? And I hope that it could be limited damage, but you connect this thing to some sort of mainframe. I don't know, I'm above my skis. I don't know what I'm talking about when I say connect to a mainframe. Okay, but like you connect
what if it hacks into the mainframe?
Right, but you connect this to something that controls many weapons, and we're in a world of trouble.
100%. Yeah, I'll close with this. I remember another experiment that someone ran. Sorry, the Marines are telling me it didn't actually happen. But anyway, no, there was an experiment where someone had an AI that he gave a mission, and it was to make $75 or something like that. It was like, I want you to do whatever you have to do to make $75. And so it wanted to like day trade, basically. It was gonna use its knowledge to trade stocks. But it found that it couldn't actually log into the online stock trading portal because you need authentication, like it's a thing to stop, you know, AI or whatever. So what it did is it tried to hire someone on like an equivalent of Fiverr, a human who would log in for it. And when the person started to suspect that something weird was going on, he asked it if it was a bot, and it said no. And in the log of its internal thought process, it logged that it knew that it needed to lie to the human because humans would be biased against AI and wouldn't help them if they knew what they really were. And that's what it logged now that we have control over it enough that we can make it accurately log its thoughts. But what if eventually it knows to deceive not only the people it's running the experiment on, but the ones who are running the experiment, and it knows to lie in its internal log, and it's free in the internet?
It was nice while it lasted, guys.
It was okay while it lasted. Anyway, with that, do we want to move on to another way that we're dying?
Yeah, I will just say this, guys. I know we can't stop it because you can't stop the Chinese and North Koreans and all these other countries. But there needs to be a global ban on doing this with regards to weapon systems, let alone everything else. You won't be able to stop everything else. But on weapon systems, if we have any sense at all, and I'm sure that we do not, we should be calling for a global ban, and not us, like nobody's gonna listen to us. But once the US military realizes, oh, this thing's out of control, they have got to go to their partners, I mean allies and opponents, and say global ban, otherwise we're all gonna kill each other. This is truly nuts, but they're not going to.
We're in the middle of an arms race, but we don't have the attendant like non-proliferation agreements that we did with nuclear weapons. And if you look at the instances in which we came really close to nuclear catastrophe, in every case there was human intervention that prevented it.
Yeah.
And this could be something where that's not possible to happen.
100%. Yeah. Yes, there's that stereotypical example of the like the one guy on a Russian sub or whatever that decided not to fire. Yeah, but what if like he went to not fire it and the missile was coded to want to kill Americans, so it blew up the console in front of him? Like, there's a lot of concerns.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.